going to play Mono Black in Standard today, and I just took a random list from a recent MTGO dump that I will adjust to my liking a little bit. Let me just take a look at all these cards. I don't love the Dracolich. I don't think I want to play four dress main. That sounds like you expect a lot of blue red, which could be okay, but I think I just wanna play them in the sideboard. Thought I got rid of this. Nope. Flung's okay. Dress. I don't think I want to play that many discard spells. Necrotic Fumes, Necrotic Scavenger. I think I want to play Sorin. Professor Onyx is okay, but I kind of like Sorin. I don't think I want to play Hunt the Specimens. I kind of don't like the idea of just playing a bunch of 1/1s. Like, I'll be honest, I am not a big fan of Mono Black. Because if you look at Standard right now and you look at cards like, or like decks like Izzet, first of all, your mana base is great because you're playing a bunch of double face cards, so you rarely get screwed or flooded because you have Jawari Disruption, you have Spikefield Hazard that's great at killing, you know, Thalia or other X1 creatures. Mono Green has a 2/1 guy for one mana now. They have Lotus Cobra, you know, a bunch of creatures you can kill that are really important. And a third double face card. There's one more. Hazard, Jawari Disruption. Oh yeah, Shareskill Smashing. So like you rarely get screwed or flooded because you get to play 30 lands, but you know, eight of them are spells and actually very relevant spells. In addition to that, if you look at the cards, they're all busted. It's all Goldspin Dragon, Memory Deluge, Epiphany, you know, just all the best cards in Standard. Whereas if you look at this mono black deck, I'm looking at iTwitch, I'm looking at Shambling Ghast, I'm looking at Deadly Dispute. School Upward Merchant. I mean, I wouldn't play this card in limited. Like, I seriously wouldn't put that card in my limited deck. So, I mean, maybe that this format is, you know, has a lot of X1 creatures. Maybe it's actually playable, but you get the idea. You know what I'm talking about. So that is, it just makes me kind of think that how can this be the right answer to Standard when people get to play all these busted cards? Their mana base is great. Literally every card on their on the curve of the Izzet deck is one of the best cards in Standard, and they have so many different options for it. So is strange to me that that's how it works, but let's try it because people are winning with it, and I do want to get some practice with this deck. So let's use Sturge Underclass. I'll play two Power Word Kill. I think it does kill Horror, right? The 7/8, yeah. So, two more cards. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. 23 lands? Is this deck like really playing 23 lands? Is 24? That doesn't sound right to me. Adding a few more lands doesn't sound too bad. I did want to have the third Massacre. I think these decks just want sweepers. I think if you play a deck like this, then maybe I just play another Valky, then your goal or like your plan is to play against a lot of aggro, I think, and just hope for the best because you have a lot of sweepers. So I just tried to build the deck that way. Go blank, Duress, Flunk. Extra removal is always good. Confront the best. I don't actually know what this card does. Target Planeswalker from a graveyard. Remove the loyalty. Actually, yeah, let's not play that. I could play like one more. Let's see. If I play against control, I'm gonna need to cut a bunch of like sweepers or removal spells, and I need to bring in enough cards. And I have three Duress, one Check Trap, three Goldblank, that's seven. I can bring in Scavenger, that's eight, and I'm boarding out at least three Massacre, maybe some Blood on the Snow, some Power Word Kills. Yeah, that should be okay. So you should always check if you have enough cards to bring in and take out, and if the numbers add up and if everything makes sense. So I have one more space in the sideboard. I don't really know what to add. I think I want to have like another removal spell against like mono green or these decks. So maybe just having another Power Word kill seems decent. Against Horror, I currently have every removal spell actually does the job. And against Dragons, I don't get to use Power Word kill. So maybe I just need like one more Infernal Grasp. Yeah, I'll try one more Power Word kill. There's a lot of white weenie and mono green. So, all right, this is the deck. I don't actually remember what is in my deck list now, but we can use the untapped extension for that. And traditional standard play ranked. This deck, let's go. And let's see how it goes. This deck is very popular on the ladder, but again, like when I think of, you know, the cards I can be playing, and I imagine playing Eitwitch, then I just don't understand how that can be very appealing. Oh, I mean, that's a decent hit. I'll try that. No need to play the Mauling on turn one. Because we have no play for turn two. So if I don't draw a land, I'll play this as a land on turn two. If I do, then I'll reconsider based on what my opponent does. Mill yourself. Then if there are three or more creature cards, transferring this into a 3-3. Okay. So we're going to be attacking for one, playing an Eitwitch, and passing. Or green black, okay. Mulch. Oh, okay, interesting. So that's actually a creature deck. Mill deck with possibly that two drop creature that if you have enough creatures in your graveyard, it is actually a 5/4, I believe, which is a pretty decent deal for two mana. So this is gonna flip. Which is fine, I can just play a 1/4. I could also play Valky, but I think I would rather try to get a land next turn and then just play both my Valky and Grasp. I could have tried to... Oh, three more creatures. Okay, it's not really flipping just yet, so never mind. I could have tried to just, you know, chump block with Eitwitch. Or just, well, trade in this case. Which would bring me closer to my fourth land, because I would get to use the two mana signs thing. Begin of your upkeep, mill a card. Three tap, exile a creature, card from your graveyard, draw a card. Okay. Well, I have a treasure for my lulf. That's a weird word. Attack for two, and I'll play you. This doesn't have flying or anything. Well, the tokens have reach anyway, so hopefully. Hopefully the Planeswalker is going to survive the turn. Our opponent's doing a lot of milling, but they still have to mill the third creature. It's calculation, all right. Another one of those. It's not legendary. Oh, it is legendary. It is a legendary artifact. Yeah, that's what I thought. So let's start by, it doesn't block, so max one of my tokens die, so this would have two counters. There's no way I'm adding more. So let's start by drawing. Blood in the Snow, nice. So this is one of the key cards in the deck. It kills all creatures or all planeswalkers. So usually you play it as a sweeper against creatures, which also brings in a creature, a planeswalker from your graveyard with mana value equal to your snowlands. So you usually just bring a planeswalker back, and it's a pretty big swing in the game. Obviously not going to play it now. Wondering if I should kill this. Probably not. Could make Faceless Haven into a creature. Just really pressure the opponent. Probably leaving Eyetwitch back. I could also just play Valky. See what they have. I think that's better than attacking with the Haven. Although it's a lot of damage if I attack with the Haven. Because that lets me... After I attack with Haven, it also lets me play either Valky or Infernal Grass. 4, 6, 8, 9, 10. I can attack for 10. I'll just attack with all... Oh, I wanted to leave the Eyetwitch back. That was kind of awkward. Well, that is unfortunate. I guess I could just block with Valky if need be. Oh, I could also turn into that. That's not too bad. I guess I can just win with the flyers. I don't really need to do anything right now. I can just attack for 7 next turn. If I keep my Valky around. Yeah, that's fine, I guess. You killed my planeswalker. They better find something with reach. That's not it. Katsure! To put on the leash. Yep, so. Pay 4. Cost 4, right? 4. Transform into a big flying dragon and attack for 7. Well, actually it's 9 because they can't even block the other token. Well, they didn't really do anything. Like, this is that's the thing. Like, did I really learn something about my deck in this game? I don't really feel like it. Go blank seems really good. I mean, they're trying to get a full graveyard. They're trying to play a slowish mid-rangey game. They're on the play, on the draw, which means that the discard spell is gonna hit even harder. What are my bad cards against? I think Soul Shatter is definitely not what I want here. Valky is also probably not what I want. It's unlikely I'll get to attack or block with it, so it's kind of like a bad discard spell, but I'm also playing a bunch of sweepers, and then like this is in play. I think I can board out Valky. I think I want like extra removal. This is not a great combo with go blank actually, but other than that it does look pretty decent against their deck. I'll try it in. If it's bad, it's bad. Shambling Ghast. That's my problem with this deck, is I don't really know how to sideboard with it, and I kind of just want to sideboard out some of these bad cards, like some of these bad one drops, but I don't know if you can really do that, because it's also like a good combo with Deadly Dispute. Not really a good combo, I mean it's still 2 cards for 2 cards, but plus you invest a bunch of mana into it, but I think I can board one out at least. I don't really want to draw Shambling Ghast in this matchup. I mean, it lets me play something a little bit earlier, but... I'll just board these out. I don't know if it's good or not. Shambling Ghast, there we go. Merchant, Sorin, Sorin. Okay, well, I guess we keep this. I could have also boarded out like one Sorin. Doesn't seem like the most necessary card for this matchup. No? Oh. Okay. Board out two shambling gas, draw the other two by opening eight cards. I guess this black deck does look good against creature decks. I will give it that. Because like, what are they really supposed to do? Like, they can't really kill you early with all these pack leaders or whatever, because you have these stupid shambling ghasts. Like, look at this. They can't really ever get in with these. I could actually even attack. That's how crazy this is. That feels kind of ambitious, but since I have another one, they don't really want to kill it with a removal spell because I'll take one of those creatures with it. And they don't really want to attack into it because I'll just trade for both of them. So it is doing a pretty good job right now of just keeping their creatures back on defense. Okay, well that's a really good card. Now I'm in actual trouble. Yeah, what do I do now? I can't even really kill the chariot. It's a little quiz for you guys. Is there a way for me to kill the chariot this turn? Not if my opponent knows how to divide damage. For which you should have this thing on. Unchecked. Auto-assign combat damage, uncheck that so that, for example, like if the chariot attacks and I block with both shambling ghasts, intending, to they both die, I give it minus one times two, so it should die. But if my opponent wants, they can just deal four damage to only one of the shambling ghasts and leaving the other alive, making it only a chump block. And sure, I'll have one trigger go off, but it's still not gonna be enough to take down the chariot, because only two of them deal damage, one of the triggers is dealing in minus one. So if my opponent knows how to split damage, then I will never be able to actually deal with the chariot. Okay, what is this? At the beginning of your upkeep, exile two cards from your graveyard. If you can't, sacrifice this. So I'm kind of looking for a go blank. I think I will be doing a bunch of chump blocking and hopefully draw into a go blank. Should I try blocking with everything? Just to see if my opponent knows what's going on. Maybe I should do it. Do you guys think it's a person who knows what's up and they have that little thing unchecked, or it's just someone who just clicks on things in Arena to get things done as fast as possible? I really shouldn't be blocking with everything. I'll just do this. Get myself a treasure. Looking for those go blanks or massacre. Does this have indestructible? It does not. So this actually kills the Egon too. There's nothing I'm missing, right? It is a legendary god, but it's not like an indestructible god or anything. Yeah. Okay, well, we can do Sorin and Powerworth Guild, but I can also just play Lolth. Actually, I should have taken four, because then the extra creatures are better for protecting the Planeswalker. Yeah, I should have definitely done that. That was a mistake. Was definitely a mistake, yeah. That wasn't good. I think now I play this to get a lifelinking guy, and then I can use Powerworth Guild on the Egon. Okay, well that's a problem. That is an actual problem. Now I can. I think I will let them attack. Will I let them attack? Kill the token. Could also kill the chariot right away, which is probably my best bet. I don't think they would just attack with everything. It doesn't make sense. The 2-2 tokens, like, doesn't really make sense for those to attack. I think I need to kill the chariot. It also just is one of those cards that survives survives a sweeper, so killing it here is actually probably decent. I twitch. I'm just not doing anything. I don't know if this is really a game I'm just happy to play. Like, I'm just throwing cards under their bigger cards. Obviously, I haven't drawn a sweeper yet, but this is what I signed up for. Like, I signed up for, you know, playing with Shambling Gas and Night Witches, and that's what I'm drawing, and it's not really doing me any good. Even if I draw a Meanwood Massacre, like, that still is not going to solve that many problems. Oh, they still have the dead guy. That guy in the graveyard, too. I wasn't sure if I should have sacrificed the Eye Twitch because I kind of need the sixth mana for my Blood on the Snow. Wait, they did not attack? What the hell? What just happened? Why would you not attack? The Minook Massacre, hello. Hello there. We can play it for three, but also my board dies. So actually, that is not that great. I would like to get rid of those Skyclave Shades, but I think I just play the Goldblang here. Make a token with Sorin, maybe draw a card. I mean, obviously, the perfect play would be just play Massacre plus Goldblang, leaving my opponent with a 6-6 in play and a Planeswalker, but I don't think that's going to work. Can I make a creature with Sorin? I kind of have to. If I play Goldblang, they lose Egon, but that's it. I think I want to draw more cards. I think I need to play this now. Because they have Rend, they can get lands to bring these back, so they're very unlikely to die and not come back. Okay, well, that's annoying. Okay. There are the extra lands. I can't really picture how I'm going to win this game. That's my problem. Like, I'm picturing drawing blood on the snow, like, doing things. Like, that's okay, but I'm not going to get rid of this, and I'm not going to get rid of this one. Plus, these are going to come back from the graveyard. So, like, how am I really winning the game? Like, what's my game plan? Like, when do these little creatures, like, when do they ever do anything? That's my question. I could block with both. What's in my sideboard? I definitely do want to find a land. I guess I just block like this. Exile creature or planeswalker. For now, I just want to play lands. I could have blocked with both and then used the other one to exile Vren. That would have been one less problem to worry about. But at this point, like, I kind of just really want blood on the snow anyway. I don't think the massacre is really going to do it. Okay. So now my plan is to block Chariot when it attacks. They're very likely to make another creature with Vren and 7. So I want to kill this, and then Blood of the Snow kills everything, brings me a Planeswalker back. Okay, now we have a plan. I think Sorin is fine to make a creature. Sure, Sorin makes a creature. If I play the sciences, then I can't make a 4/3. Back. This way I'll be able to activate Faceless Haven as well. And yeah, let's pass. I can also activate the Merchant twice. I think my opponent should have been attacking like way earlier too. Like, I don't really understand why the 7/7 is not attacking, for example, or, you know, why they haven't really been pressuring me a little bit more. Yep, we did see that coming. Attacking is fine. I will allow that. All attacking me. Screw the planeswalkers. Love it. You love to see it. So these are blocking here. I kind of just want to take the least amount of damage, right? So this is going to block here. Eyetwitch blocks the 7/7. 5/3 is currently attacking me, so I can block that. And I can trade for a token. That way I take 8, but I gain 4. I hope I'm not missing it. Oh, there is a big 7/7 attacking as well. Okay, so this is not trading. This is blocking here. What? I really hate how the creatures are just jumping from one side to another. Like, can you please... Is this... No, that's not attacking. Okay. Oh, 3/3 attacking. Sure, we blocked that. All right. I would have actually preferred if one of my planeswalkers died, so I could bring it back, but I think this is also fine. Like, bring it back with full health. Skyclave Shade, you got it. And another Skyclave Shade. You got it. Infernal Grasp. So, Blood on the Snow, bring back the merchant. I can try to kill this first, but then I know that doesn't make sense. Maybe they won't realize they have a rich guy. Nope, didn't happen. I mean, I gained two life anyway, so I'm attacking one way or another. Destroy all creatures. Pay six. Bring back the merchant. I could actually bring back the Eye Twitch, because that is better at attacking. Oh, they have a 3/3 land. That they can use that to kill one of my planeswalkers. Oh, in that case, I definitely want the merchant, because that is gonna allow me to make a treasure, and with that I can use the grasp to kill the land. So this is gonna give me a card because I don't want to lose it. Yeah, I should have done that first, but it doesn't matter. Okay, well. They kind of just walked into the Blood on the Snow. Not that they really had a much of a chance the way they played, but they should have definitely attacked me like way earlier, and then they shouldn't have used Rend to make another token. Like, they just kind of over extended for no good reason, really. That's a lot of Skyclave Shades. Yeah, now I'm just looking for another Goblank so I can sweep the board and play the Goblank and then just leave them with nothing. This is also fine. Like, now they see that probably be able to find another sweeper. They can't really block, so I'm killing Wren. I'm attacking them. Yeah, well, I don't know. Kind of a weird victory, because I don't think I should have won this game. Like, if my opponent just plays correctly, I think this game is much closer. But hey, we take those. Claim prize. All right, well, imported deck number 10, 1/0. I don't know, like, imagine playing against a really good player in like a big tournament, you know? Like, I think these Monoblack decks, they definitely could be a good choice for ladder, where your opponent doesn't know your deck. They don't know, you know, they're playing against these control decks with a lot of sweepers. Like, they don't really know what they're playing against most of the time. But imagine playing a big tournament, playing one of these qualifiers, you know, one of these SCGs, like one of these, you know, the set championship or whatever, and then your opponent gets paired against you. You see their deck list, you immediately know what's going on. You have been practicing for that event, so you know what's up, and I just don't really see my opponents walking into all my stuff that easily. They are getting priority, so they probably have a removal spell, which is fine. Could have Jewari Disruption, which would be pretty good against the Dispute, which I probably want to play now then. Sure, let's do it now. I really don't want to get this like Jewari Disruption. Oh yeah, my up.
We have 8 cards now. That's a little too many. My problem with this deck is also just the lesson cards are not very good. I mean, it sounds like I'm trying to come up with things that make this deck look bad, but I'm just trying to, you know, I'm just, we're testing for the set championship. I just wanted to give this deck a try, so I don't just ignore it. I'm just kind of thinking in my head competitively, like thinking like, yeah, okay, would I ever play this deck in a big tournament? That's why it might be sounding a little negative, but I'm just trying to be realistic. That's what I'm saying. Vanishing Burst, that's cool. We get a treasure. I don't know if that was necessary, like kill my 1/4. They better have an answer for my Planeswalker now. Nightwitch. I just wrote a deck highlight on this deck. Esper Control. Let me just take a look at what they might have. Soul Shatter, Meat Hook Massacre, another Siphon Inside. What cards have Foretell in that deck? Hellbreaker Horror, Memory Deluge, Celestus. So this, oh, Wash Away. I see what it is. Okay, in that case, we're gonna just play as many cards as possible, try to develop, not sag the treasure. I don't have to. I could still do it when they flashback this. I can still. Oh, wait, that's not a Foretell card. That's my exile card. Never mind. Yeah, in that case, I probably should have gone for the Planeswalker. Celestus is fine. Attack for 1. Definitely can attack with Faceless Haven. I think that would also be kind of reasonable. Play my Lolf. Well, that's not going to work. Okay. Okay, what about now? I can grasp 1 token and attack the Lolf with another one. But I think it's better to just attack it with both. Because if they have like a removal spell, which could be likely, then I wouldn't get to kill the Planeswalker at all. I guess I still have Soul Shatter. I can also make Faceless Haven. They're not getting priority, so I'll just attack with both without killing the token. Now I can make Haven and kill something and block. I only block once. Three, make Haven. If I play another land, then I can cast 1, 2, 3, make Haven. Then I have 1, 2, 3, 4. Still not enough, so I guess we're playing the Hive. That's fine. Okay. Let's see if they have a problem with me drawing two cards. Okay, I'm not killing anything. I will activate this though. And I will just try to get aggressive now. Because I don't know if their deck is very well set up to handle that stuff. If I play another Haven, I have 4, 5, 6. I don't have enough snow mana to activate both next turn, but I can still have it in play. I think it's better to just play Field Overrun. Actually, no, I think I want to use Field Overrun on the turn when I want to kind of lure them into blocking with one of the lands and then just have a surprise Field Overrun to make it not be a possibility. Question is, do I want to play the Merchant or no? It makes them have to play a Sweeper, a Massacre for four. It's like that kind of makes them have to tap out, and I still have mana enough to sacrifice something and draw a card. Yeah, that seems reasonable then. It's very likely has to be a Sweeper, right? And they could try to survive one more turn. I guess they do have blockers. No, that is a Sweeper. Yeah, that's the Meteor Massacre. That's fine. X is 1, so I can sacrifice you. Well, it doesn't matter which one. Two tokens are actually quite decent. I don't think I want to pay 7 mana to just run into like a 3 mana counter spell. I definitely want to play 2 snow lands now. 2, 3, 4, 5. They could activate the 3/3. So let's see, what's my play? Field of Ruin. I mean, I could just kill it with an Infernal Grasp, but I still have Soul Shatter for a possible horror. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 6 mana. They can't Flashback Deluge. It is pretty likely they make it into the land, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I can use Grasp, and I have what? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9 mana to activate Faceless Haven. Then I'm going to have 6 left. I'm going to use this. I'm going to have 4 left, and I'll still get to play these two. So that seems good, yeah. They make a 3/3. Yeah, before blockers, that dies. I'll use mana from this and this. Kill your 3/3. Oh, I guess they can also have a removal spell because they also get 2 mana still. Nope, okay. Take 5. And play my Snowland and cast the Best Summoning. And now the question is, I also want to cast the Shimbling Ghast I think so, because if they sweep my board again, then I just attack with two Faceless Havens. I do have the six Snowland. Okay, let's do it. Syncopate, yeah, that's not going to do much in this game. Main deck, main phase, Memory Deluge. That is a good sign. Well, we somehow did it again. Duress, check for trap seems good. Blank's good. This is not great with blank, but I think it's just, I mean, just need a creature. It's a cheap creature that I can play early. I don't think I want Power Word Kill. I might want to have some number of Infernal Grasps because I think they are somewhat likely to have the horror. So I want to have some answers for it. I mean, I could also just catch it with the discard spells, but if they ever resolve it, that would be kind of a problem. Oh, Massacre goes out for sure. I can board out. Actually, the aggro plan is not that bad. Maybe I board out like one Dispute. I would like to have like one Infernal Grasp in the deck without knowing their list. Actually, I have the Hagra Mulling, so that makes it two removal spells for the... Oh wait, I also have a bunch of blood on the snows. I don't want that. Okay, that changes everything. I could also put this in my deck, as bad as it sounds. Infernal Grasp, I guess you come back. All right, let me try it like this. Blood on the Snow is still okay-ish as a way to bring back a Planeswalker. Like, it's basically a 6-mana Planeswalker from your graveyard into play. It's not great, but like against these control decks, they're gonna have a bunch of counters, they're gonna have a bunch of heroes' downfalls or whatever. So it's not the worst card ever. Plus I can use it to destroy their Planeswalker, bring back mine. Yep, keep seven. The problem with having answers for their... Is there something 2-mana that I might want to duress? Like in Historic, sometimes you want to duress instead of playing your creature because you want to take Search for Ascanta, even though that's not a very popular card at the moment. Right now in Standard, I don't think there really is much, so let's just start with the creature. Obviously, in the dark, it's better to lead with a creature because if I start with this and then play duress on turn two, that means I'm dealing one damage, but... Depending on what exactly is in their deck, that could change. Like, right, for example, now they can negate, whereas they wouldn't have been able to do that otherwise. Exactly. So you have to factor all of these things in. It's possible Duress was a turn one play instead of this. Definitely. Would not have been the worst. Let's continue playing my draft deck here. That was really fast. They get to play lands off of this. Exile one of them. You may look at and play the exile card. You get to play lands. So yeah, they get to play lands. Ooh, nice. Now I'm not sure if I want to go Soaring Duress or if I want to go Lolth. I think Lolth into having a big... Board is better. Wow, okay. Okay, that works. All right, I'll play one more match. Hopefully we get paired against something aggressive because I also want to see how this gets when your opponent is trying to beat you really quickly with, you know, mono white, mono green, that kind of stuff. Siphon Insight. Swamp. Opponent goes first. That's a pretty bad hand. I mean, it is a deck where I want to play a land every turn. But then again, like, imagine playing against white weenie or mono green. Like, I can't imagine ever winning that game. Yeah, I'll just mulligan. Oh, the mirror. Well then, my hand is not very good for the mirror. Oh, green black. Okay. Deadly Dispute? Nope. What? What is this? Well, that's unfortunate. I guess I'm discarding these two. Yeah, I mean, that makes the most sense. Who's playing Goblang main deck? What the hell? Do people ever get to play against aggro? Like, imagine playing mono green or white weenie here. Discard two, aka time walk. Okay, I'll take that. The witch. All right. The twitch. Let me remind you, this video is sponsored by Channel Fireball Marketplace. So make sure you check that out. And if you do some shopping in there, you will be able to... You can support your local game stores and also the content creators. You can also use my code, JUZA, to support this content. So you will get to see more mono black control in the future. I'm blocking with both. I'm pretty happy with that, I think. Holy crap, an actual giant growth, sort of. I did not see that coming at all. Well, I think I need the treasure. I could have actually taken 2/1s and tried to set up a defense big enough to protect my planeswalker. I think that would have actually been better. Yeah, I think that might have actually been better. Because now if I play this, I get behind on mana because I have to sack the treasure, so there's no way I'm casting this next turn. And they can just attack the planeswalker. And I don't really have any good blocks. So I think the other play might have been better, but let's try it like this. I can just take some damage now and maybe play an Onyx next turn. Go to 6 immediately. Hopefully have it not die, although they can just double menace it. Wow, no fear. Just bumping their menace guy. I guess I'm not getting priority, so they know I don't have a way to kill it. Jesus, that is just so aggressive. What the hell? Does it get exiled? It does get exiled. Do they just fold to one Meat Hook Massacre? Is that what it is? Play Onyx, plus it, have it die. Doesn't sound great. Okay, I do need to find I do need to find my sweeper. Yeah, well, I don't really have a better plan than this. Blood on the Snow would be nice. Soarin' Land Grasp. Well, that's a bunch of cards I can't really use all that much. I think I need to take the land just to be able to top deck Blood on the Snow. Maybe Soarin' was also okay. Like, I make a 2-3 lifelink, and then I can... I mean, it still doesn't really do all that much. They can just kill me with the lands now. I think they should just try to be aggressive. If they just attack me with the land and the token, I go to 10. I clearly don't have a sweeper. I could have one now. Yeah, Planeswalker's also good. That also works. Well, well, well. It doesn't really block. I have to. Do I have to plus this? Or just draw a card, I mean? I'm at 12, and then I take 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. No, and then I die. So that doesn't work. me, planeswalker, and me. So I can't save the planeswalker. I might as well try to save the most life points. 3, 4, 6 mana. I'm kind of inclined to keep one of the creatures back, so I can use it for dispute. That still leaves me with the Blood on the Snow out, so I'll just block one, take the rest. Meat Hook Massacre. Wait, and I get to kill the planeswalker? What is happening? Oh, they probably have a removal spell though, because if they don't, they would have just activated one of the man lands for sure, right? You might have just realize how menace were. Yeah, they're reading their card right now. So I'll get to kill the lands too. This shouldn't really be happening, guys. Why is this happening? I can also play Deadly Dispute, because that makes me that draws me cards. Do I need to do it though? What do I get for my creatures dying? They lose one. I don't really care about that. If I play Deadly Dispute, I still have X's 3. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm doing that. On the other hand, if I do it for 4, then they can't save this with the +2/+2 thingy. But they already played 2. I don't think they have another one. And they are getting priority for something. That is making me a little scared, though. So I probably just do it for 4 anyways. Just to be on the sure side. How likely it is they have that? I mean, why are they getting... Oh, they're getting priority for Lair of the Hydra. They clearly don't have a removal spell. If they did, then they would have killed my guy to keep their planeswalker alive. So it's not a removal spell. They could have +2/+2, in which case I am not dead because, you know, okay, I'll keep it around then. I'll do it for three. I think the priority they're getting is just for the lair. Yep, I will be gaining a lot of life. Once again, I have absolutely no idea how. Oh my god, no way! That's brutal. Learn, gain four, holy crap. Wow, that was brutal. That was absolutely brutal. Once again, I have no idea how we're even in this situation. Like, my opponent lost the Planeswalker for no reason. They used their bump spells for seemingly no reason. No good reason. I mean, the two Goblangs were absolutely brutal. I had to discard a Planeswalker and... Was it a Deadly Dispute or... I'm actually not sure what it was, but all four cards were cards I was hoping to use. I Twitch, you got it. Soul Shatter, perfect card. I guess I'm just passing. They have another Goblang. I'm probably just rage quitting and flipping my table. iTwitch does not attack. Okay. Interesting. I think I'm keeping that in my hand. I don't want to get screwed by another Goblang. Again, flyer stays home. Okay. Professor Onyx, finally, kill that with Soul Shatter is not the end of the world. Did they actually use it? They didn't even use it yet? What the hell? They played the Planeswalker and went to combat. I'm confused. Okay. I don't really want to kill it, but I think I have to kill it. And then they probably take the 7 mana thing that makes 3 creatures, which I just sweep with the Massacre, so it's not the end of the world. Okay, let's kill it now. I don't want to go to 6, I don't think. Aggromoling. Okay, that can take care of the land. Do they just not have the mascot thing? What is happening here? I can't even attack with one of my Faceless Havens, I think. Don't tell me you're gonna jump block. Oh. Okay, let me just say that the resource management for my opponent is not the best. I have no idea how long I'm still in this game. I literally played one Meat Hook Massacre. And that was kind of it. And somehow I'm here with an even board, basically, because these don't do anything against the Faceless Haven, and three cards in hand. What is happening? yeah, we can keep passing. I mean, I guess I'm just waiting for a Planeswalker here. I mean, I guess we both are, but I... Oh, this doesn't kill Planeswalker. It's only a creature. Okay, I thought it was a Planeswalker as well. I see no reason to not activate this and attack for a lot. Do I even want to play Power Word Kill? Like, do I even care? My Faceless Haven dies. Like, does it matter? I don't think so. Sure, you have it. You got it. I'd rather have an answer for something bigger. Like, I don't care if my land dies here. It's not a big deal. That's not how I'm going to win this game. Blood on the Snow. Well, that can bring me back a... Lolth. Kill creatures. Okay. Destroy creatures. Pay six. Oh, wait. No, they... Oh no, it's exiled. I'm stupid. I forgot that it's like, I was looking at all the cards. I thought it was my graveyard. Okay, well, now I was making fun of my opponent and now it's me who just threw away an important card. But hey, the idea was there. Yeah, these goblins are really good against this. Are they just never going to attack with this? Like, what is going on? I could have done that first. Oh, I'm keeping that in hand. Any Planeswalker would be nice. I have three exiled. Okay, there we go. So I can. I can activate this first, attack with it, and then play my Lolth. Does it leave me with enough mana for a Power Word Kill? If all of a sudden they decide to block this turn, three, make this attack. They block, I tap the Haven, and this. I have two swamps and this left, so that would exactly not leave me with enough. So I'm going to tap five swamps to cast it. Make two tokens and pass the turn. Scry, okay. The thing with scrying in their deck is they're just probably seeing a lot of 1/1s and a lot of lands. So the only cards they are looking for are like some of these big Planeswalkers. But at this point, I probably have the advantage because I already have some creatures in play. Meat Hook Massacre, be my guest. Still, the creature does not attack. That's interesting. Lose one. Make this. Oh, let me draw one first. Actually, what I should have done is I should have just made two tokens and then cast Blood on the Snow and made two more tokens. I need to start killing them somewhat fast, so that probably would have been a pretty reasonable thing to do. I think our opponent is kind of like mentally checked out. They're not scrying, they're not blocking with the land. What is this? The other side. Whenever you gain life, you may pay one. If you do, put a plus one counter on each creature you control, they get trample. Okay. You got it. Okay. We're gonna make. Oh, wait. Oh, actually, yeah, that's fine. I just bring it back, I think. Do I want to sweep the board here? Not really. Yeah, not really. I'm just going to play it as a 6-man and bring it back. This doesn't have trample by itself. That's cool, I think. Maybe that was a little bit of a spew, but I think it's okay. I could attack and then play Massacre just to deal with their board. Like, I'm getting counters back on my Planeswalker, so that's okay. I mean, I don't really have to do it, I guess. I can just keep drawing cards. That's also fine. I just don't want to get randomly screwed by their Massacre for one. That would be kind of awkward. I can definitely attack with a creature or two. I can attack with two, maybe. I can also just play two removal spells. What is this? Pay three life. How much do I care about that? Not that much, I guess. I should have played this first. I should actually do it this turn, yeah. Because if I draw another Planeswalker, I certainly want to play it. Oh, Valky, hello. 1, 2, 3, 7. And then I don't have mana to protect it, so I'll wait a turn. Okay, no attacks needed. I could have attacked with one at least. Like, one is definitely a decent attack. Like, if they want to double block it, then they're losing the witch, which is not something they want to do. I'm gonna run out of time. 15, 19. Top one? Is that the Minhoop Massacre? Pass two attackers. Okay. Nothing. Well, I'm done waiting. Is ward spell or ability, or it is? Well, I guess I do need to gain some life back at some point. So I need to find Soren. I don't know if I can really keep activating the the Planeswalker that much. But I can just exile their graveyard too. I can also cast this for X's too. Just to have it in play. That's not the worst. Yeah, I'll do it one more. Sure. This is going to be the longest video of all times. I wonder what the card is that they have in their hand, because they chose to keep it on top and they haven't played it yet. I'll do a little bit of attacking. Then do this. Sacrifice a bunch of creatures, put extra counters on this. Okay. Play you. Sacrifice 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Submit. Oh wait, that's not... Oh, wait, this is not making 1/1s. I thought it was the other thing. Oops, I'm gonna take a lot of damage here. That is not ideal. That is not ideal. That is actually bad. Okay, this could be good. Well, I almost killed myself. After a long hour game, I'm gonna kill myself here. That's gonna make this video a lot funnier. Mm-hmm. For some reason, I thought that card made 1/1 tokens and just did something else. Like, it was, I thought it was a card I cut from my deck. But clearly, it is a little bit different. Sure. I have 12 cards left. Oh my god, I'm gonna need to start attacking. I'll just attack and play the Massacre and just kill them with the Faceless Havens in two turns. I don't want to just wait around forever. Okay, no blocks, that's fine. I hope I'm not killing myself with this, but I don't think so. Play this for X2. I don't really care that my board dies. I'm going to gain some life. They're going to lose some life. I'm going to get more counters on this. It doesn't matter which one I keep. There's a million triggers. Gain some life. Make some tokens. Play another man land. Let's play another creature. Another creature. Still have the power to kill up, and next turn I can play the power with kill on their blocker plus attack with a, oh, this I could have played this as well. It doesn't really matter. I just want this game to end. I think they're looking for like one more Professor Onyx or something. I'm really curious what this card is. Like, what is the last card in their hand that they chose to keep on the top of their deck three turns ago and they never played it? Sure. One day I'll learn how to turn off Discord sounds, but it won't be today. Activate this, sure. After all these years, they kept three mana untapped. I am I have no idea what's happening here. Okay, let me just try to do this. Plus two trample, draw a card. Wild size. Is that the card I'm thinking of? You will kill this in response. I think they're dead on board now. Activate this. Please don't tap my Faceless Haven. Okay. Okay. Wow, I can't believe this game took 40 minutes or something almost? Holy crap. That's gonna be a long video, guys. Go Blank comes in. That was probably the longest game of Standard I played in a really long time. What does this do exactly? If it reveals their hand, you choose a non-land card, exile it. They lose a lot. That's okay, probably. Scavenger looks decent as well because it's flying. I don't think I want Infernal Grasp. Flung's okay. Power Earth goes okay. I guess Shambling Ghast wasn't the absolute worst. But it also wasn't really the best. Oh, Soul Shatter. Actually, we do have Planeswalkers. Maybe I just don't want removal. Like, removal was kind of bad against them. And the game goes long. Like, I'll keep Goblang, but I don't think I want that much discard spells. Like, I definitely don't want Duress. Like, the game... This is kind of like the... When you play Jund, like, in Historic or Modern, rather... Or when that used to be a thing. Like, you didn't want to have Thoughtseize in your deck because at some point the game became a top deck war. Like, it kind of... The same thing happened here. The game at some point becomes a top deck war and you don't want to draw useless discard spells. So this at least exiles a graveyard, which means the 3-1 Shades or whatever, which they will probably have. But I don't think I want, like, actual discard. I probably board on, like, one of those shady cards. It's either that or Deadly Dispute. Probably like one Shambling Ghast. Longest game of Standard of all times. No big deal. Not a great hand, but I'll keep. If this ever goes to game three, I'm choosing to let my opponent go first. Because all these go blanks, like, I'll be happy if I have an extra card and they have one less. It doesn't matter, I guess. Yeah, okay. No third land, huh? So let's see, are they getting priority? They did not get priority when I went to attacker, so I could actually make Haven an attack. You know what? Actually, no, I don't think I want to do that. I'll just play iTwitch Pass, kill whatever they play, and then I just play Planeswalker on an empty board. But attacking with the Faceless Haven wouldn't be the worst. Probably. Actually, I can't really do this because I need the flyer in play to protect my... Planeswalker. So as weird as it sounds, I'm gonna be am I gonna discard Deadly Dispute? That's so weird. Yeah, I mean, I guess. Maybe the Massacre is worse. So now, even if they kill my flyer to attack this, then it gets an extra counter, so... They would need that plus the pump spell or something, and I don't know if they can possibly keep those pump spells in their deck after sideboard. Swamp, and I assume Powered Go-Go's. Perfect. I just want to play lands, I think. Oh, no, don't have those. Taking the 7 mana card would have been reasonable too, but I kind of just want to play lands so I can double activate the Faceless Haven. Okay, that's kind of nice, actually. Drains me a bit in the process. Powered Powered kill. I think I will actually kill it. Make this into an attacker. Just kill it right now. I don't want any kind of shenanigans happening here. Okay. Okay. They have one mana up and they're getting priority. All right, show me what you have. Yep, you got it. So they go to five. I can activate my Planeswalker one more time. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I just want to go aggro here. Okay, that plays right into the Blood on the Snow, so we can do that. I'm probably keeping the lands in hand. Destroy creatures. Bring back my Planeswalker. Make tokens. And pass. That's fine. Oh, Valky, hello. I can play that. They don't have any man lands. I could even play it and immediately exile the Eye Twitch and play it myself. I don't think even that would be ridiculous. I'll draw a card. Because I kind of don't really want to let them have it. Like, I don't want to take the random chip damage. This lets me play it. And I kind of just need to do things fast, so being a little more aggressive doesn't sound that bad. High Twitch and Witch. Look, would you look at that? So they're planning on scrying again, I suppose. I could just jam the Planeswalker here, make tokens. Doesn't even play really into another sweeper because I still keep the Faceless Haven. Yeah, that seems reasonable. I don't even want to activate it. I don't think I really need to draw the cards and just lose life here. Like, seems like I'm wasting a card here, but I kind of just don't want to take the damage here. Make some creatures pass. Like, that feels like that's the only way I can possibly lose this game. You know what? I like this guy. Okay. Play you, play you. Oh, I could have played the witch first, and it doesn't matter, I guess. Play the witch, play a night witch. Play this, make tokens. And you have one turn to draw another massacre. Even if they do, like, I'm just pumping up more tokens. Well, that was an interesting interesting run with mono black. Definitely the deck was a little better than I expected, but I don't really understand how it's winning. A lot of the games we were winning was because our opponent just kept throwing things away, plus we just kept playing in these weird decks that just, like, last round my opponent's literally playing Giant Growths in their deck. Yeah, well, it kind of worked out, but that's the thing. That's what I think about these black decks. I think you can play them on ladder, where the opposition is definitely a lot easier than in the set championships kind of event. Plus, your opponent doesn't know the list. But if you play this in, like, a really big tournament, I just expect my opponents to always make the good plays and, like, actually attacking with their lands the way they should be, and, you know, doing the stuff they were just not doing in this match. So. Probably a fine ladder deck, but I have my still reservations as far as this goes for a big tournament. But who knows? Maybe we'll see a lot of it in the PT. So thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.